I've gotten a lot of questions concerning Snorlax and whether or not it has any predators, and if those predators might be Aggron or Tyranitar. So let's take a look into Pokémon Ecology and try and answer that question. Snorlax is a large solitary Pokémon that lives in montane forests. It is one of the heaviest Pokémon, only being outweighed by various legendaries and Pokémon like Avalug and Stonjourner. Like most other large-bodied organisms, Snorlax is mostly herbivorous, but in this case it probably wouldn't pass up some meat if given the opportunity to scavenge. Its Pokédex entries state that it needs to eat at least 880 pounds of food per day, which is hopefully hyperbolic since Snorlax itself only weighs about 1,000 pounds. But it is much easier for large organisms to meet their caloric needs if they don't have to worry about chasing down prey, and instead feed on the abundant plant life found in their habitat, like berries, vines, or even humans' rice granaries. This is why most of today's large terrestrial organisms are all herbivores, like elephants, rhinoceros, giraffes, and cattle. But most herbivores often get eaten by carnivores, so what is eating Snorlax? Would Aggron or Tyranitar want to eat such a large Pokemon if there are often better options around? Aggron is another giant, formidable Pokemon that potentially overlaps in habitats with Snorlax, given that its Pokedex entry states it claims entire mountains as its territory. Aggron has large horns for fighting opponents, a high physical attack stat, and armor made out of thick metal, so it is sure to be dangerous. But there is one flaw in the hypothesis that Aggron preys on Snorlax. Aggron is also an herbivore. While it does need to consume large quantities of iron to build its impressive metal hide, it likely gets most of its calories from trees and other vegetation found on its mountainside. Aggron seems to be based on a combo of a rhinoceros, a ceratopsian dinosaur, and a T-55 tank, of which none are carnivores. Its mouth seems much closer to that of a modern-day tortoise and could be used for snipping off branches or eating plants that would be difficult to consume if it wasn't plated in steel. This Pokemon might also utilize agriculture, as apparently it's been documented moving topsoil and planting trees in its territory. Hold on, does Aggron actually stand for agriculture? Anyways, if Aggron is an herbivore and not likely to hunt down Snorlax, is Tyranitar any better adapted for the position? If you've seen this video of mine, you'll remember that I compared Tyranitar to modern-day bears. This Pokemon is quite large and fearsome looking, but doesn't quite have the weaponry or speed that you would expect from a full-time carnivore. It does appear to have fairly large canines like some other carnivores, but those could be used for intimidation purposes or for intra-specific combat with other Tyranitar. So instead, I think this Pokemon is another one that is getting most of its calories from plants. Like Aggron, it has a very durable hide, so maybe it's eating cacti, since it seems to select for more arid environments, but I have no trouble imagining Tyranitar stone edging an unfortunate slow double to supplement its diet or scavenging from a carcass and scaring away its competition. So if Tyranitar isn't trying to murk Snorlaxes to stuff their faces with, is anything hunting Snorlax? The answer is probably not. Once fully grown, or in this case fully evolved, a lot of giant animals are pretty much left alone unless they are injured or sick. However, their smaller, more vulnerable offspring are often targeted by predators, which is probably bad news if you're a munchlax surrounded by a bunch of hungry Sneasels and your parent is only watching the insides of their eyelids. So in summation, Aggron is a farmer, Tyranitar is a desert bear, and Snorlax is mostly left alone because it's just too thick. If you want to see other videos like this one on Pokemon Ecology, remember to subscribe and check out my channel, and as always, thanks for watching and happy researching.